Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today in this video I'm going to show you how to fix error code that is 0x800-73712, or if you're receiving error that is 0x800F081F while updating your Windows 10 to version 1909. So if you're receiving this error code, then please follow the steps shown in this video. Now the first step is to run Windows Update Troubleshooter. To run Update Troubleshooter, go to the Start menu, click on Settings, click on Update and Security. Click on Troubleshoot, click on Windows Update, and then click on Run the Troubleshooter. And once the troubleshoot is complete, restart your computer and then try to update Windows 10 once again. Now in case still you are facing the problem, then restart Windows Update Services. To restart Windows Update Services, just type in Services in Windows search box and then click on Services. Find Windows Update. So here you can see Windows Update. Make a right click and then click on Restart. Make sure that the Windows Update service is running over here. So if it's not running, make a right click, then click on Properties, then set the Windows Update to Automatic, then click on Start. If this one is highlighted, click on Start, then click on Apply, OK. So just make sure that Windows Update service is running, and you can always make a right click and then click on Restart to restart the service. And then you can try updating Windows 10. Now, the next step is to run DISM command. So copy this command. The command is provided in the video description. And copy the command and then type in PowerShell in Windows search box. And then make a right click on Windows PowerShell app. And then click on Run as Administrator, then click on Yes to allow, and paste the command in the PowerShell window and hit the Enter key on the keyboard. Now once the scan will complete, you can restart your computer and then try updating Windows 10. So let the scan complete. Once this is 100%, restart your computer and try updating Windows 10 once again. In case still you're facing the problem, then update Windows 10 using Update Assistant. So to use this, open browser on your computer and then type in Media Creation Tool in Google search. So when you type Media Creation Tool in Google search, the very first link is Microsoft link, which says download Windows 10 disk image. Click on it. Then use this Update Assistant to update your Windows 10. So click on Update now. A small exe file will download and it will go ahead and check your system for update, and it will update your Windows 10 to the latest version. So click on this exe file, run the exe file, click on Yes to allow. It will check the update and it will go ahead and download and install the update on your computer. In case still you are facing the problem, then you can use this media creation tool to update your Windows 10 to the latest version. So click on download tool now. If this does not work, only then you can go ahead with this step. So click on download tool now. A small exe file will download. You have to run this exe file. Click on yes to allow. Now media creation tool will come up on the screen. Now let me inform you that this is a long process. This process may take some time because it will go ahead and download the complete Windows 10 file along with the latest update. So depending upon the speed of your internet, it will go ahead and download the file. The file may be around 5 to 6 gigabytes. So this process will take time, but I'm sure that this will go ahead and resolve the problem for you. Agree to the terms, click on accept. Now let me inform you that do not worry about the data loss, because upgrading Windows 10 using media creation tool will not erase any kind of data or application from your computer. I'll tell you how. So Let this complete first. I'll show you what to select next. Now you have to select upgrade this PC now. By default it will be checked. So make sure that this one is checked, which says upgrade this PC now, then click on next. And it will start downloading Windows 10 along with the latest update. Now once the download is complete during installation, after this it will give you this option which says choose what to keep. And by default, keep personal files and app will be checked. By default it will be checked. So make sure that this option is checked which says keep personal files and app. So when this is checked, you will not lose any data on your computer. Then click on next and continue with the installation. Now during the installation, your computer may restart, and once the process is complete, go ahead and log into your computer, and this way you can get rid of these error message while updating Windows 10. So that will be all. Thank you so much for your time, and please like this video and subscribe to my channel.